Memorial Auditorium as we prepare to pay tribute to one of the most exciting lines ever to play the game of hockey, the French Connection. To start things off, please welcome your 1995-96 Buffalo Sabres. Board and counsel for the Buffalo Sabres, Robert O. Suedos. This man, along with his brother Seymour, brought to Buffalo its first NHL franchise back in 1970. Please welcome Northrop R. Knox. And finally, please welcome Sabres Chairman of the Board, Seymour H. Knox III. And now, the moment we've all been waiting for. This right wing came to the Sabres in 1972 and quickly established himself as the vital link to the French Connection. He was voted by his teammates as the Sabres MVP in 1975, the year the team went to the Stanley Cup Finals. He also finished that season with 100 points, the first Sabre ever to do so. He was an All-Star in 1973 and in 1975, and finished his Buffalo career with 222 goals, 330 assists, and 552 points. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome number 14, Reddy Robert! For hat tricks in a career with 21. This natural goal scorer kept Buffalo fans cheering for almost 750 regular season games between 1971 and 1981. He still holds the Sabres record for most goals in a season by a left wing with 52 and most points by a left wing with 95. In his career as a Sabre, he totaled 695 points. Please welcome number 7, Rick Martin. One of the greatest lines in NHL history. He was the original Sabre, drafted first overall by the Sabres in their first ever draft in 1970. He started his career in Buffalo with a bang, winning the Calder Trophy as Rookie of the Year in 1971. He played the duration of his NHL career with the Sabres and is the Sabres' career leader in games played, goals, assists, points, and game-winning goals. He is the only Sabre ever to wear number 11, which was retired in 1990. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Hall of Famer Gilbert Perreault.
gentlemen, and thank you all for coming tonight for what is a momentous occasion in the history of our franchise. In the 26-year history of the Buffalo Sabres, there have been many fond memories. From the time of the award of the franchise to reaching the Stanley Cup Finals only 5 years later, to defeating the Boston Bruins in four straight games in the 1993 playoffs, fans of the Sabres have experienced some great moments. But in the history of our great franchise, no single line has captured the hearts and imaginations of the fans of Buffalo and the Niagara Frontier the way the French Connection did. In René Robert, Rick Martin, and Gilbert Perreault, our fans were treated to the best that Major League Hockey had to offer. I speak on behalf of the entire Sabres organization when I say welcome to the Buffalo Sabres Hall of Fame. I presented the Sabres Hall of Fame Sabre to Gilbert Perreault upon his induction back in 1990. Now it is my great pleasure to present René Robert and Rick Martin with their Sabres. Welcome them also to the Sabres Hall of Fame.
I'm going to try not to break my neck here. Actually, I'm the only member of the French Connection who's really French. You know, I don't know if you noticed over the years, but Martin's name is Rick, not too French. And Perreault's name was actually made up by his family. Thinking a French guy could stick handle a little better. As you notice, my shoulders got a little broader over the years. And it's strictly because I carried them for so many terrific years. Sincerely, I must say that I've been very fortunate. Fortunate enough to be part of an organization that gave me the opportunity to play a game with people who share the same passion, the passion and the love of hockey. Thank you to the Knox families, Seymour and Nordy, Mr. Suedos, but most particularly the late Punch Himlach, and to my dear friend Joe Crozier. And to my dear friend Joe Crozier, who believed that this unknown player could do well playing right wing with Gilbert Perreault and Richard Martin. Special thank you to all my teammates for those exciting years. This wouldn't have been possible without you, so wherever you are today, thank you. To be mentioned in the same breath as the production line, the youth line, and indeed any other hockey line that made a distinctive mark in hockey is truly an honor. Sue, Michael, Melanie, my family, I, j- Yes, I can't name them all because I've just got too many here. I might forget some names. But thank you for your support over the years. It's been tremendous. Gil, Rick, you can now rest. You don't have to carry me anymore, but thank you. It felt good to be carried by two tremendous hockey players. Last but not least, to the greatest fans in the world. Thank you.
Thank you, thanks, Mr. Knox, Knox Brother, Mr. Swiddle. To get a franchise in Buffalo in 1970 was a great move for, you know, for this town. And I was very lucky to be part of it for so many years. And I was very lucky to be between those two guys there. We really had a great time together for 7-8 years. We played together. And of course, I'm never going to forget the fans in Buffalo. Thank you very much for the great night, and thank you very much.
All right, thank you. I really didn't prepare a speech tonight. I just thought I'd come out here. I didn't know how I'd feel. And I got to say, it feels great to be back. As Gilbert mentioned, first and foremost, I would like to thank the Knox brothers, Seymour and Norty, and Bob Suedos, all the people that brought hockey to Buffalo. Thank you very much, and I'm sure they thank you. I had the chance and the opportunity to play for some great general managers, Punch Imlach being the one that brought me here, and I owe Punch a lot. I played for some great coaches, Joe Crozier, Floyd Smith, and others, and I want to share with you a telegram that I received tonight before the game. It was very touching and close to me. It said, "Dear Rick, congratulations on the retirement of your jersey, but let me remind you, I retired it long before the Sabres did. Your friend, Scotty Bowman." At any rate, we got to play with some really great players here. When you think of guys like Don Lewis, Craig Ramsey, Danny Gare, how many teams could say that had a checking line with 230 goal scorers and a 50 goal scorer? Jerry Korab, Roger Crozier, the list goes on and on. We had a lot of support. We were maybe the most well-known line, but I'll tell you what, we had one heck of a hockey team. It was a lot of fun to play in this building. And finally, I would like to, I've waited a long time to say this, and you fans are the reason why we play hockey. There would not be any sports if it weren't for the fans. And I tell you what, you guys are the greatest fans in the world. Thank you.
Gilbert Perreault became the first Buffalo Sabre to have his jersey retired. It is now my great pleasure to present Rennie and Robert and Rick Martin with their ceremonial jerseys symbolizing the retirement of their number.